What's that? It
says low tier grand finals.
The final set. Potentially two, I guess.
Yeah, potentially.
Yeah, but we'll see. I don't know. Mike's been looking pretty strong with Zelda. Hasn't really dropped stuff.
Yeah, I mean, the benefits of maining a low tier in a low tier tournament.
Yeah, you get to shine.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a handicap. Well, not a handicap tournament, but a skill cap tournament.
Yeah.
Battlefield.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. I already banned Final.
Okay.
I'm glad that they banned
Dreamhack. Yeah. Okay, Fountain's gonna be good, because
Fountain seems like a common choice. Yeah. It's probably the stage I've seen the most.
Yeah, yeah. Zelda can recover. Roy has a pretty decent horizontal. He has way better horizontal in terms of horizontal recovery than Mario.
Yeah.
And it does, or like it when it hits you, it does, like it pushes you farther, so it's good in that. So I don't know, recovery wise, they're both, I guess, this doesn't really favor anyone over the other, just Zelda naturally since she's floating. Forward smash call off out of the corner.
It was good, but no kill, so. And that's.
Yeah, forward smash.
That's what happens when you overextend with Roy against Zelda.
Yeah.
You get kicked. You have to play really careful.
What do you get off grabs?
Oh, okay. Nice. Alright.
Oh, man. It thought
that was weird how that sent him.
Yeah.
Up smash is a weird move.
Okay. Okay. Dancing Blade.
Yeah, I don't know too much about Dancing Blade, but I know shit like that can happen.
Yeah. Yeah. Let's see. Okay. Yeah, Zelda's definitely trying to drift away and just place bears at the edge of Roy's range.
Up E to down smash. That was interesting.
Okay, fair.
Back throw. Get him off stage.
Off of it was good.
That was really nice.
Yeah. Function the
For a second I thought he was gonna go for the down throw, but down air, but he knew better.
Oh. Nice DI down. Zelda's caught on the platform.
Zelda's down air is a meteor, but it's like the worst meteor in the game.
Yeah, it seems really soft. It's like your down smash.
Yeah.
And then it's, I don't know, it hits sort of like almost instantly, but it seems real soft.
Yeah, I mean, anyone's going to be able to meteor cancel that if you know what meteor canceling is.
Yeah, yeah.
All right, so we caught him on the platform with the forward smash.
Oh, okay.
Side B is an interesting move.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, there's that good recovery. But I think Mark would have been a good one.
Probably. All right.
Shield poke.
Yeah, shield poke there.
Yeah, went ahead. It's extra jank because you had the mid-platform height.
Yeah.
It's like going through him, so it's weird.
That was a good way he landed and shielded. He anticipated the F smash. That might be it.
Yeah, he keeps throwing. Okay, yeah.
Oh,
okay.
Alright.
Catches the jump.
Alright.
Yeah. Yeah, I guess the draw of Zelda is just super baiting you into like getting into her poking you with her fairs of bears.
Yeah, it's really good, and that move is very strong.
Yeah, yeah. Yes, it's a mini knee. It's almost like, it's like it's like the knee but on Luigi.
Yeah.
It's weird. Alright, let's see. We got a character switch.
So we have a run back, stage run back.
Mm-hmm. I'm okay with them. This is a nice looking stage.
Yeah, the music's pretty dope too.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, but Kirby gets a home field advantage. Yeah, this Kirby is finding its way in more.
Yeah.
Way easier.
I mean, that's what you have to do. I don't really know what Zelda does against Kirby, except, you know, down smash will keep him away. And then, you know, of course, fair or bear will kill super early.
Yeah.
But Kirby's a little bit harder to hit.
Mm-hmm. Plus, the way Kirby wants to hit is just getting in there.
Mm-hmm.
What Roy wants to do is, like, kind of like Marth, just sort of space.
Yeah.
That's what Zelda wants to do. And
Zelda can do it better.
Yeah,
and,
can do it better, so this could be good.
Yeah.
If you see, Zelda get, I don't want to say overwhelmed, but as overwhelmed as, like, you can get as just being slow and floaty.
Yeah.
That's what's mostly going to probably go down and stuff any zoning stuff before it happens.
Yeah. Alright, so he got one off. It was, you know, he was getting to pretty high percent, so it's definitely time for him to get a kill.
Yeah, no, it's definitely on Mike to get those kills, like, at okay percents. Because you definitely can. Kirby's light. You can definitely get those fair kills. This one. Way earlier than with Roy, actually.
Yeah, well, for sure.
I don't know, actually. Because Roy can't recover as well as Kirby can.
Yeah.
So even if you send Kirby pretty far, not sure.
I think the thing is that Kirby's way lighter.
Yeah.
So he suffers way more from the knockback of the move. So down throw seems like it can lead into stuff, but I don't know about a sweet spot. Not quite gonna kill.
Yeah.
It's, you know, forward smash is an okay move, but it's a risky one to just throw out.
It is very risky. But yeah, it's good. It's good there.
You know, he's got him off stage. Gets an opportunity for something else.
How can you really edge guard? How is he edge guarded so far? I feel like he hasn't really. Okay, well.
It's a bit tougher to edge guard the floaties, but you sort of just have to hit them or get them to use their recovery options. Spot dodge neutral B. Itself is extremely bad shine. I don't know, I'm pretty sure I got killed by it today though. I think I was recovering and I just got hit by it and died. She can do it out of shield, which I think is kind of nuts. Turbo.
Yes. Yeah.
He did what he was supposed to do in the matchup.
Yeah.
I would say.
Stairs.
What do you think about that pick? Stadium?
I think Stadium is good because you're going to kill Kirby.
You know.
Okay, alright.
I thought he might switch.
Okay, so now I don't know. Now it's kind of good for Roy, because forward smash will definitely lose a smaller stage in general than Fountain, I think. Or at least off the top.
Honestly, I don't think Fountain is that high. Well, yeah, I don't know.
Yeah, Fountain's pretty much the same as Battlefield.
But I guess it helps. The thing is, Roy only has a few vertical kill options.
Yeah, I could only really think of Upstairs.
Does Upstairs even really kill vertically?
Yeah.
I feel like his down smash might kill vertically easier.
Okay, well,
I don't know.
That could be true. When I play Roy, I don't use down smash, so I don't know how that moves.
Well, I don't blame you, because a lot of his moves are bad. But I think, like, with Marth, right? Tipper down smash sends him up.
Okay. Yeah, Marth.
Yeah.
Marth, tipper, yeah.
So the opposite of that with Roy is if you hit him on
the
close.
The Mecha King turnaround, did you see that? They just, turn around in place to forward smash
yeah.
when the person then launch. Yeah, the Gunman doesn't seem to be using down smash too much either.
I don't see him use it either.
That's cool.
He's got a very aggro Marth, but it's kind of funny because he goes and gets all these hits on Zelda, and she sort of just like, alright.
Yeah, she doesn't move. She just takes it.
I mean, he's getting damaged, but he's gonna get. Oh, alright.
Well, yeah, there you go.
Because he's gonna need to put on more, but when you get the forward smash.
Yeah. Yeah, otherwise if you're gonna kill with like a bear or something, it's gonna be a lot more percent that you have to put on.
Yeah, so I think what Turbo wanted here with this switch was maneuverability.
Okay, that makes more sense, yeah.
So that's really what he's been capitalizing on. Roy does have that much.
Yeah, Roy at least has a pretty good dash dance.
Yeah. Dash dance, a good wave dash.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, definitely good movement.
Yeah.
Nothing even better up there. Decent short hop.
Almost lived it, but. I was talking to Turbo earlier. You remember when he played against KJ and we were all wondering why he counterpicked this stage with his Peach? Do you remember that?
I remember that. I remember that.
So I asked him about that and he told me Peach was his first competitive main and that he was really comfortable on that stage. But that little indentation in that transformation.
Yeah, the lip.
Well, in like the very center where the ground is kind of like sunken in a little bit. He said it's like a really strong spot for Peach because you can't really, you know.
Wait, on the fire transformation?
Yeah.
Okay.
Like we saw you got those techs.
Yeah.
So.
That's cool. I got in there.
Yeah. It was definitely some interesting insight. Think about this pick though. I mean, it makes sense for him to be switching to Kirby here.
Yeah. Just so he can also take advantage of the survivability.
Yeah.
So that makes sense. But how's he gonna get his kills?
That's a problem.
Yeah. So we'll see, I guess. Back here, didn't do much. He's gonna have to be probably up air for a smash deck.
He's just gonna have to outplay him a lot.
Yeah.
I mean, but that's kind of this matchup.
Yeah, that's low tiers.
Low tiers versus Zelda in particular, because if Zelda just gets a couple of good reads, whoa.
Yeah, that's some cool reversal stuff. I like whistle looking. Yeah, jumping in the fair is embarrassing. It's out.
I'll bear through the pressure with Kirby. That's a thing, I guess.
Is that right?
Questionable. On both of their parts, really.
Yeah, yeah. But I don't know, what kind of punish do you really need to do?
Not gonna kill you, but it'll put him off stage. Yeah, he wanted the down air, but...
Okay.
Wow.
That's cool form.
Yeah. Kirby stuff.
Kirby's like Jigglypuff, and that like the first couple jumps have like the most distance.
Yeah.
To them.
So life for Zelda is kind of tough when she's not, you know, trying to wall out with those with her fair and bear, because a lot of her moves are like very committal. Like, forward smash is nice to throw out for people to run into, but it doesn't have a whole lot of range, and it's slow. Jab's probably a little bit more reliable, honestly. He wanted that. Seems like he's trying to get something going with these side B fireballs, but
yeah, they haven't really been working out too much. It's kind of tough to time and just like get it in a spot where
I feel like it's not really worth it.
Yeah, I mean, since Kirby can see where it's going, it's really easy to avoid when you have more than one jump.
If you get hit by it, is it even gonna hurt you that much?
Yeah, no, it doesn't really do anything. The one thing I've seen it do really well on was it covered a sweet spot side B.
Yeah.
For against spaces. Oh, okay.
Zelda's shield is not great, so you don't want to be hanging out on the platform under somebody.
Mm-hmm.
So we have a reset.
Alright.
Oh, what was it? 3-1. 3-1.
Yeah, I think you went game and watch two games, and then,
game and watch. Yeah.
Low tiers are hard. It kind of was not the best matchup spread for you, honestly.
Yeah.
Like, the Kirby, I think, is probably doable for Ness, but Roy is hard for Ness and Game
and
Watch.
Yeah, kind of hard. I don't know. Honestly, with these low tiers, I'd probably just have to learn a couple.
Yeah.
But we'll see. I didn't practice too much.
Yeah.
Ness is kind of my favorite. like my low tier pocket to play. So that's some fun with him.
He's fun.
Yeah, he's real sick.
And now we're seeing Turbo's Nez.
Yeah, so we'll see. Best color too.
Yeah. I wonder what his reasoning was.
Yeah, right.
Maybe he just wanted to switch it up.
Yeah, right. See what's going on. Oh, that was interesting.
Yeah. That.
Oh, almost got the 6-man.
I saw him do that against you, but he was a little too late this time.
Oh. It's always nice when you get the forgiving ricochets on the MD. I'm pretty bad at getting those.
Yeah, it's hard. I don't know. I feel like in this matchup, right, if you throw out the PK fire while she's in the air, she's just gonna, that's gonna happen.
Yeah, definitely.
If you can hit her with it and then capitalize with like a grab or something, then it's not bad, but if you miss with it, yeah, that too I don't like.
Yeah.
Turbo's still managing to keep this pretty even though, so. Extra damage, I guess.
Yeah, sure.
But, alright.
Okay.
I like that. It's definitely different. Yeah, that'll do.
Yeah, recovery is hard for Nez. I was definitely struggling. I was definitely doing some dumb double jumps, actually.
Yeah.
I feel like double jumps are really important to conserve.
You did a double jump cancel up there.
Oh, yeah.
I don't really know too much about double jump cancel. I just know it's a thing.
Yeah. You can use it to alter momentum, and you can use it at any point after you jump the first time. With Nez, it's really awesome because you can go, you can stay in place, or you can go backwards or forwards. It's like a hook, and depending on when you do it, when you do your aerial, you move. You have a huge degree of control.
Yeah,
it's real awesome.
I feel like Nez's fare is really unfortunate now in this game because I didn't realize or remember that advancing fare has a way smaller hitbox because the hitbox moves. Impact.
Yeah, it has sort of like a Doppler shift.
Yeah. It's kind of unfortunate, but I mean, if you do a fadeaway, then
it's
that's
a pretty
not
good
too
wall,
bad.
Oh, pop him back up. Oh. Yeah. Okay. Bit of a scramble, but got the. I wonder.
Yeah, so that wound up working out.
Tipper.
I don't know. He has a tipper, but as far as I know, it's for reflecting projectiles.
Oh. Okay. I'm not super sure. I'll be honest.
Yeah, I don't know if it has a stronger hitbox or anything.
Okay. Well, no, he was just rotating characters.
I mean, he's pretty well known for doing that around here, so...
Yeah, no.
Why should the low tier tournament be any different?
Ooh. Well, Neutral B is a pretty good option there. It's really hard to sweet spot Zelda.
Yeah.
Just because, I don't know. The line is such a long line, and it's a straight line.
Rambo was telling me her up B goes in 16 different directions.
Oh, yeah, so that's less control than you want. I learned today that Falco in Smash 4 has limited direction rules.
Really? What happened to Falco, man? He fell so far.
Yeah, it's rough. It's like you have to wait. You have to wait like 3 to 5 minutes before an aerial.
Makes me sad. At least he had some cool stuff in Brawl. Brawl Falco seemed like he was pretty dope.
I kind of like the new Shine. If I didn't love Melee Shine so much, I would think Brawl and Smash 4 Shine. Falco Shine.
If you're playing like a more projectile-based game, right, that Shine is not bad at all because it comes out really quick in front of you. It's probably way easier to deal with projectiles.
Nice sweet spot. Play.
Okay. Yeah, I don't.
Yeah, that down or that down air is never gonna connect through Roy up B, and even if it does, I don't think it's gonna kill.
No.
Or I don't know, it might have high percent because you're locked out of a meteor cancel.
Yeah.
For 40 frames after you.
But I feel like it's gotta be really high percent in order for it to kill.
Yeah.
Falling Nair doesn't seem that bad.
That
grab. Falling Nair was Zelda.
Okay, yeah.
I think somebody brought. Was it you that brought that up?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. It didn't seem too bad there.
I know I saw. Rambler was trying to fall in there on me, but it never connected, so I never saw the follow-ups yet. But I think ZFS had Falling Nair to up smash.
One time. That's interesting. Cool.
Yeah, it didn't look like it was something that you tried to connect, but it looked like something that just sort of happened because of weird DI.
Alright, so.
Trees get saved by the tree, except, that's such a weird angle.
Yeah, and Roy, unfortunately, does not benefit from hitting characters through the platform.
Yeah, no. Unless, I guess, you up smash.
Oh, yeah? Alright.
Yeah. Commentator's face.
Yeah, really.
Alright, got some space going on now.
Honestly, I feel like Rambler's trying to do more than he has to sometimes with Zelda.
How so?
I feel like you could just fair and bear all day. I feel like Roy doesn't have strong answers.
I know what you mean. Roy's been swinging now, though. They're scrambling.
Like, that teleport is cool, but, Alright, that was a sick bait, I'm not gonna lie, but, you know.
They look cool. Okay.
I feel like sometimes, bad moves are bad, and you shouldn't do them. You know?
That's definitely sensible. No, okay, alright.
We'll go back.
Man, that was close.
It was close.
Yeah.
Trying to think.
Okay.
Falco's worst move is probably fair. It can combo sometimes, and I like it only because it has slightly more range than Nair.
Mm-hmm.
But other than that, it's not a move you just want to throw out willy-nilly. And it's not. It's one of those things that you don't see many Falcos just throw out. It's something to. And, like, I don't know, a much better example is probably, like, Sheik, you know? A lot of moves have, they're very specific purpose, and, you know, she only uses, like, two of her throws, really.
You never want to F smash.
F smash is awful. You know.
I feel like something's changed in the match.
I think, it might just be comfort. Turbo might be feeling himself a little bit more now, you know?
Right. Yeah, he is going in a bit more, trying to space it, I guess.
Like I said, you know, with Zelda, well, it's nice to experiment with stuff, something like I was saying, bad moves are bad. You know,
this is game two, right? This is game two?
I think this is game three.
It's game three, okay.
Yeah. He, Turbo went in Espros.
Ah, you're right, you're right. Okay.
But yeah, you know, he said more opportunities to play the Roy matchup, and, you know, he's been getting a lot of, forward smash reads. That was
sort of
interesting.
Okay. Yeah, getting some cool follow-ups from Roy. Yeah, you're right. Maybe he has figured out what he sort of wants to do.
Yeah.
Okay.
But like I said, Will might be tempted to want to do other stuff. You know, I feel like with Zelda.
Yeah, that was sick, but he did get punished for it. So you're right. Yeah.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it, you know? It's. Those two moves are great, and, you know, they kill, they pressure shield really well, which Roy does not have a great shield. It's only, like, slightly better than Mars.
Hey, good shit, dude.
Okay, all right.
Yo,
yeah,
I was not ready for
the
run back.
That's the grand finals.
There you go. Yeah, that's good stuff.
Yeah, good shit, dude. Good shit.